Now we'll study the relation in angular and linear velocity. When we talk about a basic circular motion, when a particle is moving in a circular path, we know that about the center, it moves in such a way that always the velocity vector is tangential to the circle. When the particle is moving, let us consider a small interval of time, say from t to t plus dt. In such a short duration, dt say particle goes from this point to this point. So it covered a displacement, the angular displacement d theta in this duration of dt. The distance which it will travel, it can be directly written as, or we can write distance covered in time dt is this distance. If we consider it ds, this can be written as v dt. Even if the velocity is varying, we can consider that dt is such a small duration in which the velocity magnitude remains constant. So this distance traveled by the particle can be written as v dt. In this situation, the angular displacement in time dt, this can be written as d theta. And this angular displacement d theta can be written as arc upon radius. Say if particle is revolving in a circle of radius r, it can be written as ds upon r. If we just substitute the value of ds, you can see we'll get v dt upon r. And here if we take dt on the other side, it will become d theta by dt is equals to v by r. And this d theta by dt we can simply write at the angular speed omega. This equals to v by r, or we can write linear velocity can be written as r omega, where omega is the angular velocity. It is the angular velocity magnitude or angular speed which can be written as v by r, or we can relate these by the similar expression, that is v is equals to r omega. So if a particle is revolving in a circular path at angular velocity omega, then at any instant of time, the linear tangential velocity of particle can be given by the relation v is equal to r omega. Here omega is a vector quantity and we can write about omega vector that its direction is given by right hand thumb rule. Direction as well as the magnitude as well as this relation, it is going to be used extensively in various kind of problems which we are going to study. Let us consider an example to understand the relation in linear and angular velocities. Say we are having a disc. On this disc, say we make two spots. Say this is one spot which is of red color and this another spot say which is of blue color. Now if the disc is rotated at an angular speed omega in anticlockwise fashion as seen from above. It is quite obvious if red spot is located at a distance r1 from axis of rotation, this is the axis of rotation, this spot will revolve in a circle of radius r1. Similarly, blue spot if it is located at a distance r2 from the axis of rotation, it revolves in a circle of radius r2. As the disc is revolving at an angular speed omega, both of these particles will have same angular speed. You can also write down a note. This will be helpful for you in future just to analyze the angular motion. When a body rotates at an angular speed omega, then all of its particles revolve in circular motion at same angular speed omega. So here this red spot as well as blue spot, they are revolving in the different circular paths with the same angular speed omega. Now, if we talk about the linear speed of these spots, we can say as these spots are having angular speed omega, this red spot will be tangentially moving with the speed vr, and this velocity of red spot can be written as r1 omega, because it is revolving in a circle of radius r1 and having angular speed omega. Similarly, this blue spot will be tangentially having a speed vb, and this vb can be written as r2 omega. So we can say the linear speed of blue spot is more than the linear speed of this red spot, although they are revolving in such a manner that they'll complete the circle in same time because their angular speed is same. This example is a good illustration to understand the relation in linear and angular speed.